Madagascar 2.
We've lost engine 1. And engine 2 is no longer on fire.
Hollywood versus reality. Coming up. Hey 7-4 crew, welcome back. If you don't know me, my name's Kelsey. I'm a 747 pilot. My channel, 7-4 Gear, is all about aviation. Today I'm here in sunny Los Angeles, California. The weather is great. I think it's in the mid-70s. It's in the middle of December. Really, what more can you ask for? And this is a view from my hotel room. Today I'm doing the Hollywood versus reality on Madagascar 2. It's very similar to the movie Soli, as it's also based off of a true story. It's about a lion, a hippo, a zebra, and a giraffe escaping Africa being flown by penguins. Let's get into it.
Check.
Flaps.
Check.
Engine.
Check.
Coffee maker.
Check.
That's got to be the second biggest slingshot I've ever seen.
But it's gonna have to do.
Attention, this is your captain speaking.
In the event of a water emergency, place the vest over your head, then kiss your goodbye.
New York City, here we come, baby!
Pray to your personal god this hunk of junk flies.
Personal god hunk? What?
We are go, sir.
Full disclosure, I've never flown this aircraft, so I'm not familiar with their checklist and systems. But there are some things that they've gotten right and some things that Hollywood has gotten wrong. First, one of the things they've gotten right is they're doing a checklist. Now, it's standard in all airlines that one pilot is reading the checklist while the other pilot is checking to verify that those things are done correctly. It's called a challenge and response type checklist, and that is correct. However, one of the things that caught my eye is that he mentioned struts. Now, struts can be a few different things on the aircraft, but I think what they're referring to is the landing gear here. And there's 5 lights. You have the red and the green mixed together in the same line of these struts. And usually you're not going to have green and red mixed together like that, and it's going to be something that's ready to go. Something that also caught my eye was they're showing flaps 60. Now usually if flaps go past 40 degrees, they start to act more like drag and less like lift. The flaps are something that we use on the aircraft to help the plane fly at a slower speed but maintain lift. We use those flaps for takeoff and for landing, so we don't have 7 and 8 mile long runways to take off and land on. As for the coffee maker being on the checklist, that's 100% accurate. I know a lot of pilots that have to drink coffee or want to drink coffee during the whole flight. I even know of one instance where the pilots refused to go until the coffee actually arrived on the plane. So that actually is very true. You may have noticed that one of the pilots was verifying the controls were free. That's something that we do. You want to know that the controls are free and there's not something locked or jammed or something like that. And you want to do that while you're stopped, not going 100 miles an hour down the runway. So that's actually something that is correct. And finally, you see the flight attendant inflating their vest in part of the safety briefing. That's something you will never see a flight attendant do. They always say, make sure you evacuate the aircraft before you inflate your safety vest. So that's something that Hollywood did not get right. Let's get back to the movie.
In case of a loss in cabin pressure, place the mask over your face to hide your terrified expression from the other passengers.
Excuse me, miss, but aren't these supposed to be attached to my seat?
No, sir.
Okay, boys, launch!
Hey!
On!
So you saw that the gear was down as they were flying out over the ocean. That's something that a pilot would never do. Shortly after takeoff, we verify that the aircraft is actually climbing in the air. Once the aircraft is climbing, we actually bring the gear up. The gear is usually a very big source of drag, especially on larger aircraft. I realize this isn't a massive aircraft, but there'd be no reason to have it down at that point, so the gear would go up right then. Now, gremlins are a real thing on aircraft. It's a word that pilots use when there is a system that is continually having problems and they can't understand exactly why. For an example, if the electrical system keeps having some weird fault that's happening, a pilot will say, man, I think we got some gremlins. Now, it's not the same gremlins that you're seeing here on the movie, but that is a word that we actually use, is gremlins. So that is actually real, even though it's not that type of gremlin. Also, you see the pilots flying into a thunderstorm. That's not something that normally I would do or most pilots would do, but I guess if you have no experience flying through thunderstorms, then maybe that's something that you would do. And I don't know if there's a lot of thunderstorms over Antarctica where penguins did their flight school, but that's not something that would normally happen. But I guess if you were a bad pilot, then you might do that. So maybe Hollywood got that right. All right, let's get back to the movie.
We'll go out for pineapple, my little bobbly-headed boobly-boo.
Skipper, look.
Analysis.
It looks like a small incandescent bulb, designed to indicate something out of the ordinary, like a malfunction.
I find it pretty and somewhat hypnotic.
That too, sir.
Right. Rico. Manual.
Mm-hmm.
Problemo solved.
Sir, we may be out of fuel.
What makes you think that?
We've lost engine one. And engine two is no longer on fire.
Buckle up, boys. Don't look, doll.
This might get hairy.
I'm not sure why Hollywood loves these flashing red lights and buzzers. We do have them, but they aren't usually just a random red light in the middle without any explanation as far as what is going wrong. However, what the captain did was correct. In different airlines, it will have different names, but there will be a manual on the aircraft for any type of an emergency. And you would ask for that manual, so that part was correct. However, we don't then smash the light. That is not correct. But that is correct. If you do have a light, you would ask for that manual, and then you would also ask for an analysis. In some cases, you would ask the other pilot what's going on, depending on the phase of flight you're in. Usually in cruise, which is the phase of flight they're in right now, you would both be able to see what was going on, and you wouldn't generally ask. But you would ask for that manual and then just do whatever that manual asked you to do as part of the checklist. Another minor thing here that they didn't quite get right is they referenced engine 2 as being the left side and engine 1 as being the right side. Those are reversed.
We've lost engine 1. And engine 2 is no longer on fire.
The left side engine is 1, the right side engine is 2, and that's honestly not a big deal. I think they did that in the Sully movie as well, but it's really not a big deal, but this is something that I noticed. All right, let's get back to Madagascar 2.
Attention! This is your captain speaking. I've got good news and bad news. The good news is we'll be landing immediately. The bad news is we're crash landing.
When it comes to air travel, we know you have no choice whatsoever. But thanks again for choosing Air Penguin.
Raise your arms, Murray. It's more fun when you raise your arms like this.
My goodness, doll, you're shaking like a leaf.
Rico, you've had your fun. Pull up.
Gear down. Gently now, you just want to kiss the ground. Just a little peck, a smooch, like you're kissing your sister.
I said kiss it.
Now just a little break. Just a touch. A little whisper.
I believe that's checkmate.
So as the movie Sully showed us, if you lose both engines, you're not just going to fall out of the sky like that. Obviously, that was done by Hollywood for dramatic purposes of this documentary. However, if a plane were to nose over rapidly, you would lose gravity for a little while. So that part is correct. And the lemur is correct that if you put your hands up, it is a lot more fun.
Raise your arms, Murray. It's more fun when you raise your arms like this.
I know pilots do it all the time when we hit air pockets. Something else that did catch my eye is the captain was asking for brakes, and the engines are gone and the wheels are gone, so there is no thrust reverse and there are no brakes, so I'm not really sure how he's asking to just tap the brakes. I also like how he is asking the co-pilot who's flying the aircraft to do things, and then when he's trying his very best, he's getting berated. That could happen in some cases. You will get captains that are like that, but I'm not really sure what he's expecting this person to do. There's no thrust reversers from the engines, and there's no brakes to stop, so there's really nothing else that he can do. All right, final scene of Madagascar 2.
Commence emergency landing procedure. Flaps up. Deploy.
In the world.
All outright planes and parachutes is something that people have talked about a lot, and the reality is commercial aircrafts do not have parachutes, but there are planes that do have parachutes. I was just flying one just a few weeks ago. So Hollywood did get that right, but you will not settle on the ground that smoothly, and it will not be in a commercial aircraft. Also, as far as for the captain's decision of when to pull that, obviously a time when you've lost all of your wings in the outer shell of your aircraft along with your wheels and landing gear, that would obviously be a good time to do it, or possibly a little bit sooner. As far as for the oxygen mask dropping, that actually could be a real thing. It's not actual tanks that are creating that oxygen. It's actually a chemical reaction. I talked about it in an earlier video where I explained how the chemicals mix together to create oxygen for your oxygen mask. So you're not seeing tanks there, and that part is accurate. However, the pilots, and I didn't really see from the flight deck side, the pilot's oxygen is actually from a tank. I didn't see those pilots with their oxygen masks on or where it was coming from, so I don't know about that. But as far as passengers are concerned, that Hollywood did get correct. Now, one thing that I really did like about this film is that the captain, no matter what is going on, losing the shell of the aircraft as well as the wings and the landing gear, is doing whatever he can to get the aircraft safely on the ground. In real life, that is exactly how it would be. And it actually kind of reminds me of that movie Flight, where even though things are going really bad, the captain in that case, Denzel Washington, is doing everything he can to get the aircraft safely on the ground. If you haven't seen the Hollywood versus reality that I did on Flight, I'll put a link to it right here. I look forward to hearing from you. Until then, keep the blue side up.